You can do it, Roy.
Oh,
silent, please. And questions through the microphones on the side.
After an impressive start in winning toss and making runs, seven runs per overs, then why the batsmen slowed down? Was it, they were bowling well in the middle overs? Or?
Look, I think it was a combination. We lost two cricket wickets there. Just whenever we came out of the first 10, or we asked about 12 or 13 overs, not sure when it was, we lost a couple of quick wickets then, and that slowed us down slightly. But we managed to pick that up again, coming down the back end or in the 30th over and around that. We had a bit of a platform to go again, and every time we just started to pick up that bit of momentum, we managed to lose a wicket, which is slightly disappointing. But I like how the lads come in and played with that freedom and intent from the off, which I think you need to do, and you have that confidence, and the confidence is there within the change rooms to back lads to go out and do that. And we just managed to keep losing wickets, which pegged us back from kicking on to what would have been a very competitive total.
William, two areas of in Ireland's game which isn't as strong as other areas are your ability to score fluently against spin, and then your seam attack. Is there a lack of depth in these departments, and how would you see yourself overcoming it? Is it a lack of exposure to such challenges?
I think exposure is a big thing. You've probably heard me say it 1,000 times. We've played 9 ODIs against top 8 or top 10 teams in the last 4 years, in between World Cups, which is not a lot, and you consider a lot of countries are playing 25-30 plus a year. So that's disappointing from our point of view to not get that experience and get those games under our belts. But I think the skill factor's there. I think we did slow down. I think you've got to give a bit of credit to Ashwin and the lads bowled. They bowled very well then. Yeah, we could have probably put them under a bit more pressure, but we didn't want to go too hard too soon, especially after losing those couple of wickets. And I think we started to pick up a bit of momentum, as I said, coming down near the power play. But every time we did that, we just managed to lose a wicket at crucial times. And I think the spinners bowled well, and they got a bit of assistance. And yeah, we just managed to lose those wickets at crucial times. It slowed us down. Look, we don't have lads at the minute that are coming in bowling 90 clicks, which a lot of sides potentially do. I think the lads have got great skills and what they do have, but we've come up in a very flat wicket. You see the way that the lads play. I think it's just a very good pitch in what is a small ground, and defending an under par total on that, it makes it very difficult. And once lads get a start, it's very hard to claw back. We had a couple of half chances there at the start. I probably should have taken that off that one, and he's probably on about 10 or 12 then. So that makes a big difference. You take that and you nick another one off, and all of a sudden the 20 for two puts them under a bit more pressure, as opposed to getting away for 70 off for none after 10 on a very good pitch.
As an opponent, what do you think India's main strength is?
I think they've got a lot of strength. I think that you've seen the way their batting was there. They obviously got off to a bit of a start, but they've got lads coming in through that middle lower order that can just keep the momentum going and pick the rate up from ball one. They've got lads bowling now late or mid 140s, early 140s as well, which in Australian pitches, obviously it wasn't necessarily the quickest pitch today. It was a pretty flat pitch, but I think all their games now might be in Australia from now on, so that'll assist them, and they've got a great spin attack, so I think they've got all the attributes there to go all the way.
Not having a player of Kevin O'Brien's skill operating anywhere near his best, what impact has that had on the team?
I think he's shown glimpses of that in the tournament. He came in, got 50 out of 20 balls and early on in the competition, and he got a quick fire 20 the other night, and he's got all the potential in the world. I think he only faced two, three balls today, and that can happen. But he's with the ball. As I said again, we're playing on pitches. Like the pitch today was a flat pitch, and all the pitches we have played on have been great pitches. So you haven't got much margin for error. I think he bowled reasonably well there tonight. I don't think he was too far off what he can do. But the 4 men out makes it very hard as well. And he's bowled a lot of his overs at crucial times for us. He's bowled a lot of overs in the power play. And coming down the last 15 overs, I'd say he's bowled 75% of his overs at least in those overs. So you got to take that into consideration now when you look at stats and figures and that, in my opinion, because when you come down to there, it's a very difficult job, and you can't just look at stats and go, he's not doing well. But if he bowls at that time in the game, then you expect things to be slightly different.
William, just on the team selection, was there a thought to give a game to either to Craig Young or Peter Chase, perhaps?
Look, Tomo's bowled very well, and he's done really well in every session we've had, and he's the one who's stuck his hand up, and he's got that chance to come in and impress. And obviously, things didn't go very well for him in his first over, but I thought he came back very well, and I picked up those couple of wickets, and that'll do his confidence the world of good. And he obviously strengthens our batting as well, coming in there. He can bat higher than 8, but just in the lineup we have at the minute, he's coming in there at 8, so that strengthens us all around, and he's a fantastic fielder. So I think his selection is justified there.
William, you had batted for the entire section where you said we didn't want to go too hard too soon, but the Indians bowled their overs at a very quick pace. Did you at any point in time sort of look at the scoreboard and say so many overs are gone, because they put in about 20 in an hour?
Yeah, they obviously got through their overs and they were rushing around, but we didn't let that affect us as where we were at. We knew the size of the ground, and we could always catch things up at the back end. But as I said, we just lost wickets in crucial stages there, and we lost two quick succession, and we rebuilt a decent platform. We just didn't manage to kick on to where we would have liked. But I think you got to give them credit as much as anything as well.
You've scored the highest total of any team against India in this tournament. So just in terms of batting, does that give you some confidence going to the game against Pakistan?
Yeah, most definitely. I think we've been confident with the bats throughout. And as you said, if it's the highest score against India in this competition as well, that's good for ourselves. I think that we played very well for long periods of that game there today with the bat. But it just shows how ruthless you got to be when the way India batted there. And once you get that start, you got to really kick on and score hundreds. We had a couple of 60s and 70s there. If you can turn that India 120, then it makes things a lot easier for the lad at the other end as well. And that turns a 260, 270 into a 320, 330 plus.
William, you've looked a very comfortable chasing side in this tournament so far against West Indies. You sort of execute your chase absolutely perfectly. And after what happened to England last night, you're playing in the same venue on Sunday in a do-or-die game. Are you particularly thinking about... Do you have a preference as to whether you bat or bowl first, or is your game plan surrounding the chase, or would you look to bat again first?
No, a lot comes down to conditions. I think we've won setting, we've won chasing in this competition. We've chased down over 300, and we've set 330-plus whenever we've batted first as well. And I think that on another day, being out there again, we would have gotten that 330 plus from the platform that we had. So I'm confident whether we bat or chase. Obviously, we'll take a look at things now moving on to Adelaide, but we're focused on each game as it comes. So we've only finished this one now. So over the next couple of days, we'll do homework on Adelaide, and we'll have everything behind the scenes ready, and it's just a matter of getting things right from there. So now we'll look at Adelaide once we touch down there.
William, you had mentioned about Ashwin bowling. There wasn't too much purchase on the wicket, but still he went for only 19 runs in his first 8-over spell, which most of it you faced as well. What aspect of his bowling was that you guys found challenging there?
He just varied his pace very well. I think he came on, he was bowling there whenever we had lost those couple of wickets. So He just varied his pace quite well. And when Jadeja came on, there was quite a bit of purchase there. It was a bit of more holding up than spinning, but there was a bit of grip there for him. So, look, I think maybe we could have been slightly more aggressive in that period, but I was happy with where we were at and how we had gone. And as I said, we lost wickets just at crucial stages when we started to kick on again. But on another day, we get through that and we kick on again and we get up to the totals that are going to be very competitive in this tournament.
William, India effected a couple of good catches and a great run out. So do you think this Indian fielding unit is a kind of a crack fielding unit, a good fielding unit which can be compared with some of the better units in the World Cup?
Well, yeah, you look at the fielding side that they have, they've got a very good fielding unit, so there's no reason why not. They're all fit and athletic, and And as you've seen there, he hit the stumps. I think his colleague got to run out there. If you're hitting stumps, you got chances of run outs. And they look pretty athletic as well in the field. So yeah, there's no reason why not. There's something you're in control of, is how well you can field and how good you can be in the field. So you can always improve in that area. So there's no reason why it can't be.
How do you rate leg before dismissal to go for a DRS while fielding?
How do you rate what, sorry?
The leg before decision to go for a DRS while fielding.
That was umpire's call. So if he'd have given it out, it was all way. If he didn't, then it wasn't. It was a good decision, as far as I'm concerned.
Thank you very much.
Conference English questions first, please. A couple of questions, four questions in English, please. And then if you direct your questions through Dr. Palmer, that'd be great. Thank you.
Adri.
Captain, two questions. What do you think of the way Ashwin is shaping up? Number one. Number two is, in the last match we saw the untested components in batting do well. Today we saw the spinners pull things back. How do these things matter in a long tournament like this, when you see the different parts coming together?
I think the crucial part is for everybody to score runs, to get wickets, and to bowl well, you know, because ultimately in the knockout stages, you don't really know, you know, who all you may need. So, it's important that everybody gets a bit of confidence going. And as you rightly said, you know, most of the batsmen, they've got some kind of a batting so far. The bowlers have done well. This game, the spinners, you know, they bowl really well. As far as Ashwin is concerned, you know, obviously, you know, he's someone that I always love to have. The reason being, you know, I've always pushed him to bowl in the power plays, and even I've used him whenever I'm in difficult situations. So he is he's very confident about his bowling. You know, he understands his bowling well. And I believe he has learned, you know, in the few foreign tours that he has made, you know, I think he has learned a lot out of it. And the good thing with him is, you know, he keeps improving himself. You know, every time he's part of the series, he sees the challenges and accordingly he improves. So it's obviously good to have him, and it's good to see him bowl really well.
MS, is your biggest challenge now, you've topped the group, is your biggest challenge now keeping yourself motivated because Zimbabwe is a meaningless game for you?
Well, we are highly motivated, you know, in this game also, if it comes to the points and all, you know, we had qualified for the next stage, but still, it was a challenge in itself, you know, because of the traveling schedule that we had, and a lot of boys, you know, they didn't get enough sleep before this game, because we landed and the traveling that we have to do and all of that. So every game, you know, pushes you to do something special, and I felt, you know, we overcame everything, and yet we did really well on the field. So same way, you know, the next game will be the last before we get into the knockout stages. So we'll keep improving, you know, every game. And that's our motive, you know, to keep improving in every game so that we can maintain the forward shift that we have got.
My word on Shikhar Dhawan, the way he played in the tri-series and before that in the test series. Did you have, you know, one-to-one session with him, and you motivated him? Can you share with us?
Devuta is back? No.
No, he's supposed to back on 16th.
Okay. You know, it's important to back players, and we try to do it to the extent we can. And I felt, you know, though he had a tough series, still I felt, you know, we had put in a lot of effort in him. And not to forget, without his contribution, it would have been very difficult to win the Champions Trophy. So we always believed in him. But that final step, you know, that needs to be taken from the individual. And I felt he prepared well for these ODIs. And it obviously takes time. But as I have always said, you know, it's those 15 minutes that really changes everything. And I'm glad he got those 15 minutes. And what he's doing well is in making the most out of it, because as an opener, you know, you may go through tough periods where you may not score runs, you may get good deliveries. But it's very important to think about the process, you know, wherever your limitations are, you keep improving on those areas. And whatever your strength is, you know, you make sure that, you know, whenever it is in that particular area, you make the most out of it by getting a boundary. But overall, what difference I have seen in his batting is once he gets a start, you know, he makes the makes a good, you can say, he takes that as an opportunity to convert that start into big innings. And right from the first game, you know, that's what he has done. You know, he's not someone who's happy getting a 50. He knows that we need to, the team needs him to score big runs. Is 50, you know, he eyes the next milestone, which is 100, and with him doing that, it becomes slightly easy for some of the other guys, you know, to bat around him, because he takes that responsibility. And he's someone who can also accelerate at a decent pace, you know, uses the pace of the bowler and can bat aggressively. So, you know, overall, I'm quite happy with the way he has gone forward, you know, because it's not that easy to come out of a phase where you have not scored a lot of runs. But at the same time, I think he prepared well and he kept believing in himself, you know, because it's always the individual that starts to question that belief, you know, because everybody believes in the individual, but at times you start questioning yourself. So I felt his preparation was good, and that's what really helped him score runs.
Lost five in English, Anand Vasu, second one, third. Fourth one is Gautam Bhattacharya and Japan Bhattacharya.
Skipper, Umesh and Shami have given you very good starts so far in the series, but today that didn't quite happen, and you quite quickly changed plans. How important is it for yourself to be that flexible, and how do you see the bowlers responding to your change of plans?
Well, I think that's very crucial, because if this was a very important game for us. You know, maybe I would have brought in the spinners close to the fourth over, you know, because I felt from behind that there will be assistance, because when a few slower ones were bowled, you know, it definitely got a bit of bounce. And but bounce, what I mean, it just gripped onto the surface and there was a bit of bounce for them. So if it was a very crucial game for us, you know, spinners would have come on really early. But I wanted the fast bowlers to have a bit more go. Also, the fact that they have bowled well, so you know, I thought maybe I can still use the new ball, get a few nicks, you know, if possible. But it was coming on nicely to the bat, the new ball, even though the slower one was getting stuck a bit. So I said, you know, I thought let's go ahead with the fast bowlers for a bit more time and then bring on the spinners. And that's what I really did. The flexibility from the bowler side is also there. They quite understand, you know, they don't question too much. It's not always that, you know, when the bowler is not bowling well, I change the bowler. It's also about, you know, maybe how the condition is right now. This bowler may do slightly more with the new ball. And according to that, I have my bowling changes planned. So they take it in the right stride. And, you know, that I feel is important, because at times you feel this is the time I can get a wicket. And, you know, as a bowler, you may be disappointed. But what's really good is they take it as a plan, they take it as a strategy, and which helps them to always be positive. So, you know, it was one game where they went for runs, they did go for runs, but, you know, it was just stopping enough for the batsman to play the shot, but still the new ball was coming on. So, you know, good learning curve for them. You know, maybe if they play the next game here, they'll do it slightly differently. But I think when we play in Auckland, the wicket will be very different. And as I said, this is the slowest New Zealand wicket that you will see. And all the other wickets will be quite similar to what we have played so far.
Emis, you're playing with a lot of... Emis, your team's playing with a lot of confidence. You had a lot of momentum on your side. Obviously, the tour to Australia didn't go according to plan. What has changed that your team is just sort of on top of its game right now?
Well, we have been in those difficult situations before. You know, they say experience counts, but it's not a very good one to have. You know, it was quite similar to the 2011 experience when we went to England. You know, we didn't really win anything. But at the same time, what was important was, you know, what you learn out of those series or tournaments or, you know, tri-series. And I felt the boys absorbed really well. They knew what will be thrown at them. And also the break that we got in the middle, you know, we made a conscious attempt as to take it as a break that divides the two series, you know, the whole of Australia series and tri-series as one big tour, followed by a 10-day or 8-day break, and then we go into the World Cup. And also the presence of fans really help. You know, the moment you start thinking about, you know, participating in the World Cup, the whole adrenaline, you know, is up. And at the same time, with so many people coming from India and starting with an India-Pakistan game, you know, it was just fantastic. So that also, you know, gives you that extra edge, you know, that pushes you one step further. But ultimately, the individuals will have to lift themselves up, you know, because it was not an easy test series. You know, playing 4 test matches in a month's time is very draining. And not to forget, it's almost the same bunch of players that were playing the test matches. So, you know, it was a challenge in itself, and I felt we came back strongly now, you know, with the World Cup campaign, and hopefully we'll keep moving forward with the kind of momentum we have.
MS, you used about 4 spinners across 30-odd overs. In a sense, you were almost in experimentation mode. Do you feel that's when you're at your best as a captain?
No, I'm best when the bowlers are bowling well. You know, it makes the job slightly easy for me, because you have a plan, but unless it's executed well, you know, it can make you look like a good captain, but at the same time, it may look as if, you know, what is he doing? You know, because it all depends on the execution. You may have 2 slips, and if the bowler bowls on the pads, you know, it doesn't really look good. And I feel that's where a remarkable difference has come from the bowler's end. You know, they are bowling according to the plans, and at the same time, they're quite aware of the field, and they're bowling according to the field, which is a big change. And also it's reflecting in our performance so far. So I feel, you know, it was not much of an experiment. It was more about, you know, adapting to the condition. I saw it was slightly slower wicket, so I used that extra part-time spinner that we have. And Suresh, you know, whenever he has got a bit of assistance, he has proved himself to be like a proper bowler. So it was good also. He also, you know, got a game, you know, proper bowling spell of 10 overs. So I felt, you know, it's not experimenting. It's more about, you know, using the resources that we have.
MS, two questions. One is equaling Clive Lloyd for the number of maximum number of consecutive victories, which is 9 in World Cup matches. And two, you have talked about several reasons for this tremendous transformation. MS Dhoni, the captain, after giving up the test captaincy, also refreshed in your mind? Are you stronger? Are you better as a one, even as a one-day captain?
No, I'm just the same, you know. The things that have changed is the result, you know. Apart from that, the players are the same. So I don't think that has anything to do with the test captainship. But as I said, you know, what the bowlers are doing is something that's I have not seen for a long time, you know, particularly with the Indian team setup. And, you know, we used to keep telling them, you know, bowl to one line, bowl one length, and that creates pressure and all of that. But it was more like a said thing that was listened by them. But now they have seen it and they have tasted it. So hopefully, you know, even after the World Cup campaign, once we go back, you know, play all different teams for IPL and all, when we come back for the test series or when we are again coming back and playing outside the subcontinent, they still have this memory in their head that, you know, outside the subcontinent, a lot of times you have to stick to good line and lengths, and that's something that really rewards you. And that will definitely change a lot of things for us. You know, a lot of trouble that we have been having, you know, that will be sorted. So hopefully, you know, it's something that we are thinking, you know, they will retain all the things that have been, you know, given to them or how they have learnt it. And as far as the records and the milestones are concerned, you know, the most important thing is, you know, winning the game for your country. It doesn't really matter, you know, what the milestone is. You know, definitely it's something that every player will be proud of. You know, the last World Cup, all the team members, you know, thanks to them. And the current team also, you know, because it's a team effort. At the end of the day, we play a team sport. So everybody really needs to enjoy it.
MS, what makes this Indian team such a crack fielding unit? We have seen some great fielding instances in this World Cup. AB's run out, even 2-day run out, and good catches. What's making it so special? It's the drills, fitness. What is it?
I think fitness plays a major role, but please don't quote me as the last team was not fit. You know, because you know it's an easier way of going that way. But if you see the fielders, you know, a lot of them are fit. A lot of them are, to some extent, you can say the new generation cricketers, which get slightly better facilities, you know, good ground. So, you know, diving comes quite naturally to them. Of course, the fact that all of them are quite fit. And most of them are agile on the field. You know, you may be fit, but you may not be quick. But over here, you know, if you see the playing 11 that we played, you know, almost all of them are good fielders. You know, there may be one average fielder in the whole 11. But when you have extraordinary fielders backed by really good fielders, you know, you'll have a side that can outfield some of the other side. Because when it comes to this World Cup, they are fantastic individuals, you know, who can field really well in all the teams. But they have quite a few players that you can still target. You know, some of our boys will also be targeted because the fields are big. But, you know, if on an average, if you see, you know, we are you can say, above average fielding team. And that's the reason why we have been getting runouts quite frequently. And it's reflecting in our playing also, because that, you know, that shift of momentum is needed in the middle overs. It may be a good catch, it may be a run out, but that's really, you know, something that's really working in our favour.
Last three in Hindi. One, Anand Relay. Second, Kushan.
Mahi, aapne apna pool top kar liya hai, paanchon match jeet gaye hain, aakhri match jo hai Zimbabwe ke saath pool mein, kis tarah ka temptation rahega if you have to, agar aapko dono wave karna hai ki aap kuch players ko test karna chahte hain ya kuch players ko rest dena chahte hain and to keep on the momentum agar aap wo chahte hain, to aap kis tarah se dono ko balance karenge aur kya aapki soch rahegi Auckland mein?
I think isme hame physio se input lena padega. Agar physio ko aisa lagta hai ki breakdown ke chances hai kisi player ko, to us situation mein hum usko rest denge. Otherwise agar sare available honge सिलेक्शन के लिए और ऐसा कोई डाउट नहीं होगा कि किसी की इंजरी बढ़ सकती है, देन विल प्ले द बेस्ट 11 जो भी हमारा बेस्ट 11 होगा वो हम फीचर करेंगे, क्योंकि मैचेस के बीच में ब्रेक ऑलरेडी है, सो उतना रेस्ट काफ़ी होना चाहिए. तो अगर इंजरीज का रिस्क नहीं होगा तो हम अपना जो बेस्ट 11 है वही फीचर करेंगे.
माही ऑस्ट्रेलिया में टेक ऑफ वाला बॉलिंग था, यहाँ थोड़ा सा रेनबो वाला था बिकॉज ऑफ द विकेट. ये कैसे एडजस्ट कर लेता है बॉलर और कैप्टन, और क्या ये अच्छी बात है कि इसके बाद फिर से हम टेक ऑफ की तरफ जाएंगे?
वेल, हर विकेट करना पड़ता है, क्योंकि सक्सेसफुल होने का एक रीज़न ये भी है कि आप कितनी जल्दी कंडीशन के हिसाब से अडेप्ट करते हैं. बट मुझे नहीं लगता है कि एग्जैक्टली सेम विकेट हमें आने वाले किसी मैचेस में मिलेगा, क्योंकि हम यहाँ पहले भी खेले हैं तो हमने देखा कि हैमिल्टन का ही विकेट था जो बाकी सारे विकेट से काफ़ी डिफरेंट था. बाकी सारे वेन्यूज़ में जिस तरीके विकेट बनाए गए थे वो सिमिलर थे. ऑस्ट्रेलियन विकेट्स जो है लगभग वैसा ही पेस और बाउंस था उनमें. आउटफील्ड थोड़े छोटे हैं यहाँ पे, उसके अलावा बहुत ज़्यादा डिफरेंस नहीं है. तो आने वाले मैचेस में हमें काफ़ी सिमिलर कंडीशन मिलेंगे. यू नो, नॉट लाइक दिस गेम, आप बोल सकते हैं ये एक वन ऑफ मैच था, बट ओवरऑल हमें आने वाले जो भी जितने भी मैचेस होंगे उसमें सारे विकेट्स अच्छे मिलेंगे.
लास्ट क्वेश्चन है
मेरा. मैं आज उमेश का काफ़ी कंसिस्टेंट परफॉर्मेंस रहा है, लेकिन आज थोड़ा सा चूँकि वो ये क्या फ्लैट विकेट की वजह से है या बॉलिंग अच्छी नहीं डाली, आपको क्या लगता है?
आई थिंक हम थोड़ा और ऊपर डाल सकते थे डिपेंडिंग ऑन द विकेट, क्योंकि थोड़ा होल्ड कर रहा था विकेट. एंड ऑल्सो अगर आप देखें तो आयरलैंड की जो टीम है इसमें काफ़ी प्लेयर्स हैं जो यू नो दूसरे लीग्स में खेलते हैं, सो दे आर क्वाइट यूज टू दिस कंडीशन. सो उन्होंने स्टार्टिंग में बैटिंग भी अच्छी की. यू नो जब हमने थोड़ा बॉल ऊपर भी डाला तो ऑन द राइज उन्होंने काफ़ी अच्छे शॉट्स मारे. तो एक आध डिलीवरीज को अगर छोड़ दे तो उसके अलावा उन्होंने अच्छे शॉट्स पे रन बनाए, तो उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम नहीं होता है, क्योंकि अच्छे शॉट्स आप सिर्फ अच्छा बॉल डालने को देखते हो, उसके बाद अगर बैट्समैन अच्छा शॉट मारे तो यू एक्सेप्ट इट. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि उसने ख़राब बॉलिंग की, आई फेल्ट उन्होंने बैटिंग अच्छी की स्पेशली पहले के 10 ओवर्स में. बट द की थिंग इज़ यू नो हाउ यू कम बैक. सो नेक्स्ट गेम इंपॉर्टेंट रहेगा पूरे बॉलिंग यूनिट के लिए, यू नो क्योंकि कंडीशन वापस चेंज होंगे तो उन्हें क्विकली अडेप्ट करना होगा कि वापस इस विकेट में लेंथ कौन से लेंथ पे हमें बॉल डालना पड़ेगा. सो सिर्फ इस बेसिस पे कुछ बोलना सही नहीं होगा. अगर हम क्विकली अडेप्ट करते हैं तो देन आई कैन से कि नहीं नहीं बॉलर्स ने यू नो बहुत जल्दी ये डिसाइड कर लिया था कि ये लेंथ पे हमें इस विकेट में डालना पड़ेगा.
लास्ट वन मेरा.
आपने बोला था कि पहले कि यू हैव इवन ट्राइड सेइंग टू द बॉलर्स लाइन में रन डालो, वो सुने थे लेकिन कर नहीं पाए. वो अभी क्या चेंज हुआ है कि वो सुनने लगे और करने लगे हैं? न्यू बॉलिंग कोच या पता नहीं आपने कुछ इमोशनल टॉक किया कि पिट पिट के थक गए, पता नहीं क्या चेंज कैसे हुए?
नहीं, हो सकता है सबका मिक्सचर हो. यू नो पिट पिट के भी थक गए होंगे, दूसरे बॉलर्स को भी देखा होगा, तो काफ़ी चीज़ों का मिक्सचर होता है. एंड ऑल्सो जब आप नई चीज़ें करते हो तो इम्पॉर्टेंट होता है कि वो थोड़ा सा आपके तरफ यू नो जो रिज़ल्ट होता है थोड़ा सा आपके फेवर में जाए, तो उससे आप ज़्यादा इंक्लाइंड हो जाते हो और ज़्यादा फॉलो करने के लिए. काफ़ी बार हमने बैट्समैन को देखा है कि नेट में कुछ चेंजेस करते हैं अपने बैटिंग में एंड दे आर कंफर्टेबल, बट मैच में जाने के बाद अगर एक बॉल मिस होता है थोड़ा सा प्रेशर बढ़ता है तो दे गो बैक टू देयर ओन बेसिक्स. यू नो क्योंकि प्रेशर सिचुएशन में आपको वो चीज़ करनी पड़ती है, सो दैट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन नीड्स टाइम. सो आई फील जो हम यहाँ पे 4 महीने से हैं, टेस्ट अच्छा भी रहा ख़राब भी रहा व्हेन इट कम्स टू बॉलिंग परफॉर्मेंस, मे बी हम लंबे समय तक एक अच्छा परफॉर्मेंस नहीं दे पाए, बट जो लर्निंग थी स्पेशली जब हम ट्राई सीरीज़ खेले थे उसके बाद से, दूसरे बॉलर्स को भी हमने देखा, इंग्लिश सीरीज़ में भी हमने देखा. सो आई फील ये सारी इन चीज़ों का कंट्रीब्यूशन है. और जब बॉलर्स ने ऑनेस्टली एक ट्राई किया कि लेट्स डू इट, और जब वो उनके फेवर में वर्क किया, सो आई फील यू नो that something that triggered a spark, you know, because that's something that's really needed. And hopefully, you know, ye learning hamesha unke dimag mein rahegi, to jo bhi hum aage series hum khelenge, you know, they'll keep doing the same. Aur humne bouncers bhi bahut acche tarike se use kiye hain. You know, hum un teamon mein se hain jahan pe hum bouncer bahut acche tarike se use kar rahe hain, overuse nahi kar rahe hain, but at the same time underuse bhi nahi kar rahe hain. So you know, that's something that's a big change. मुझे याद है जब 2 बाउंसर का रूल आया था तो प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में पूछा गया था, तो मैंने बोला 1 बाउंसर तो मारते नहीं है, 2 मैं अपने साथ लेके जाऊंगा. बट नाउ इट्स गुड, यू नो हमारे पास ऑल्सो हमारे पास अभी बॉलर्स हैं जो 140 के आसपास डाल रहे हैं, आउटफील्ड यहाँ पे बिग है, काफ़ी बड़े आउटफील्ड है, तो हम उसका यूज़ कर रहे हैं, कंडीशन का यूज़ कर रहे हैं. and they're enjoying it. You know, as a unit, they're bowling well. So,
thank you.